Good morning, everyone. Today is August 18th, 2022. We are going to chant Shoshin Nenbutsu Gen Junirai style. So please join me in Gassho. Please put your palms together. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namanda Butsu. Namanda Butsu. Namanda Butsu.
奇妙無量寿如来南無不可思議故法蔵菩薩印尼寺財政自在王武将刀剣諸仏浄土院国土銀殿自然幕建立無上修正願超発慶雨大愚勢五光四唯四小十十聖妙小文字法不法無量無変光無義無体公園の頂上寛一恵光普段難事無所光超日学校精進説一切群情無故障本願名号症状号四心心行願二因上等学生大涅槃一心滅道願成就如来超意高修世唯説弥陀本願会五濁悪事群情会往診如来如実言納骨一年期愛心普段煩悩徳涅槃煩上逆法再現入如修心入海一味摂修心向上昇合異の水波無明暗本来心臓死運無上不真実新人天人形一個不運無運無死下妙無暗逆心謙虚大狂気即応超絶合悪臭一切善悪凡夫人問心如来具足願仏言広大聖解者是人妙憤大利伽弥陀仏本願念仏邪見狂慢なく修行信行十字人疑難南中市南無可思インド祭天使論下中華自治騎士構想県大小公正小一妙如来本税大きい釈迦如来両我線異種光明難天寺流獣大寺出土世質の財波無権戦絶大乗無情報召喚異次小安楽賢治南行六六新行異行指導楽 億年弥陀仏本願、次年即時入筆上、唯の上生如来号、王法大悲偶世音、天人菩薩造論説、奇妙無下光如来、永州多羅漸真実、光線王朝大誓願、法雄本願力栄光、異道群上昇一心、奇入功徳大崩壊、一逆入大永州宗、特使蓮華造世界、即正真如法性人、有本能輪現人図、入正寺音寺要解、本師曇鸞了天師、上皇蘭生菩薩来、三蔵漆十条経、文殊専修喜楽法、天人菩薩論中下、報道因果顕世願、方言念故有他力、清浄心唯心人、惑前凡夫信心法、承知生じ即涅槃、一心無量光明道、超宇宙上皆不軽、同者皆生道難生、唯名浄土活入、満禅寺力遍厳宗、円満徳合観戦勝、三風三神経音言、増末法滅道品、一生増悪智具税、思案如外生明化、全道独妙不生意、高愛情三要逆悪、光明明後見因縁、皆入本願大誓会、行者成就金剛心、病気一年相応後、用意大逃逆三因、即生法性至上楽、原心航海一大教、縁起安養感一切、先祖修身反先人、法華義道小便流、極重悪人唯生仏、我薬剤非摂取中、煩悩生厳水不堅、大悲無間浄生我、本師厳苦妙仏教、憐憫善末煩無人、真宗教証後編集、千尺本願具悪説、源来生じ輪伝下、結智義乗異生死、即入寂静無為楽、一心人異能入、愚教大慈修士道、上塞無辺極浄苦厄、同有蔵。 目次集愚道心有意化心心ナマンダーブツナマンダーブツナマンダーブツナマンダーブツナマンダーブツナマンダーブツナマンダーブツナマンダーブツ
ナマンダーブツ。 Now I'd like to share the words from notes on the inscriptions on sacred scrolls. So please join me in a show. Please put your palms together. 大無量寿経にのたまわく節が特物、実法主上、四神神行、翼章画国、内史十年、脈風章者、不主章学、唯女語訳、秘宝章法等。It is stated in the larger sutra of immeasurable life. If when I attain Buddhahood, the sentient beings of the ten quarters, with sincere mind entrusting themselves, aspiring to be born in my land, and saying my name, perhaps even 10 times, should not be born there,May I not attain the supreme enlightenment? Excluded are those who commit the 5 grave offenses and those who slander the right dharma. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namanda Butsu. Namanda Butsu. Namanda Butsu.So the notes on the inscriptions on the sacred scrolls begins with the quotation of the 18th vow passage from the Larger Sutra. And since Reverend Jitsen Kakehashi's book spent about 170 pages just talking about the 18th vow, I would like to follow Kakehashi Sensei's explanation for this passage to deepen our understanding on the 18th vow passage.So it might take a few weeks to read the passage of the 18th vow. But the 18th vow is the most important vow among 48 vows of Amida Buddha. And this is the only place Shinran Shongin explains the meaning of the passage of the 18th vow in his writings. The Larger Sutra is one of the 3 Pralana Sutras, but Shakyamuni Buddha expounded the originand fulfillment of the vow in this sutra. So that Shinran Shongin said, the Larger Sutra is the fundamental teaching among the 3 Pralana Sutras. And in chapter on teaching of Kyogyo Shinsho, Shinran Shongin said, the Larger Sutra is the true and real sutra, which expounds the true intent of Buddha among all the sutras. So in chapter on teaching, he said, to reveal the true teaching,It is the larger sutra of the Buddha of immeasurable life. The central purport of this sutra is that Amida, by establishing the incomparable vows, has opened wide the Dharma storehouse and full of compassion for small, foolish beings, selects and bestows the treasures of virtues. The sutra further reveals that Shakyamuni appeared in this world and expounded the teaching of the way to enlightenment, seeking to save the multitudes of living beings by blessing them with this benefit that is true and real. Thus, to teach the Tathagata's primal vow is the true intent of this sutra. The name of the Buddha is its essence. So the larger sutra consists of two volumes, and it talks about so many things. But the core of the sutra is to teach sentient beings the primal vow of Amida Buddha. And the larger sutra talks about the 48 vows of Amida Buddha, but the core of the 48th vow is the 18th vow. And this is the understanding from Master Shantou, Master Honen, and Shinran Shongi. So when Shinran Shongi say primal vow, that refers to the 18th vow. So the larger sutra is the sutra which teaches us the origin and fulfillment of the 18th vow. And this is what to teach the Tathagata's primal vow is the true intent of this sutra means. Then Shinran Shongi said, the name of the Tathagata, name of the Buddha, is its essence. So this means that the essence of the teaching taught in the larger sutra is the name, Namo Amida Butsu. The 17th vow states, if when attain Buddhahood, the countless Buddhas throughout the worlds in the 10 quarters do not all praise and say my name, may I not attain the supreme enlightenment. So, who taught the larger sutra? That is Shakyamuni Buddha. Shakyamuni Buddha is the Buddha of this Saha world. Shakyamuni Buddha expounded the teaching to the beings responding to the 17th vow of Amida Buddha. So the larger sutra is the sutra which all the Buddhas teaches us the wisdom and compassion of Amida Buddha to grasp and never abandon us through the working of the name Namo Amida Butsu in detail. So at the beginning of the volume 2 of the Larger Sutra, Shakyamuni Buddha teaches us how the 17th vow and 18th vows are fulfilled. It said, the Buddha Tathagata throughout the 10 quarters, countless as the sons of the Ganges, are one in praising the majestic power and the virtues inconceivably profound of the Buddha of immeasurable life. This is a passage of fulfillment of the 17th vow. And next one, when sentient beings upon hearing the Buddha's name realize an entrusting heart in joy with even a single thought of the Buddha, direct their merits with sincere mind and aspire to be born in that land, they then all attain birth in the land and dwell in the stage of non-retrogression. Excluded are those who commit the five grave offenses and those who slander the right Dharma. So this is the fulfillment passage of the 18th vow. The Buddha's name in the fulfillment passage of the 18th vow refers to the fulfillment passage of the 17th vow. So all the Buddhas praise and expound the teaching of the name Namo Amida Butsu, responding to the 17th vow of Amida Buddha. And when we hear the origin and its fulfillment, without doubt, we will be settled in the stage of non-retrogression, in the stage of the truly settled to attain birth into the Pure. So the volume 1 and volume 2 of the Larja Sutra expound the teaching of the name Namo Amida Butsu. You know, I was thinking about a good explanation for this. And do you know this candy? It's called Kintaro Ame. This is a long candy, but doesn't matter where you cut, you see the same picture. So Larja Sutra is the same thing. All the passages of the Larja Sutra is ultimately talking about the name Namo Amida Butsu. So the main body of this sutra is the calling of Amida Buddha as entrust yourself to the working of my name Namo Amida Butsu. So that is why Shinran Shongi said the name of the Buddha is its essence in the chapter on teaching of Kyogyo Shinshu. So I hope today's explanation helped. And in closing, please join me in Gassho. Please put your palms together. Namo Amida Butsu. 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 This concludes today's morning service, and I hope you will have a wonderful day today and hope to see you tomorrow morning. So thank you for attending today's service.